We would love to play first. Okay, yeah, this hand is just fine. I think we will Windswept Heath for a Godless Shrine. Another thing about this deck is that it doesn't have does not have any Court of Callings, so you don't need to be as concerned about getting triple green. Not that that's usually too much of an issue. There aren't very many lands in the deck that don't tap for green, but it's something you had to be aware of before. Alright, looks like our opponent is on 5 cards, so that should be good for us. Also, obviously, Windswept Heath is a nice little upgrade to the mana base. Where if this was a Misty, obviously could not get Godless Shrine, so we'd have a more awkward spot. Not sure what decks in the format play a lot of wooded foothills. Probably some sort of Scape Shift clan. I guess Jund could play wooded foothills also. Yeah, it looks like some kind of Jund deck. I assume that's what Wooded Foothills plus Bloodstained Mire means anyway. And Tarmogoyf. Okay, sure. Yeah, Chalice for one, not exactly good. Chalice is not exactly good in this matchup, I would guess. So I guess we should aim to preserve our life total to some extent. I don't know how important that is in this whatever, against whatever we're playing against. It could be the like summoning or the Through the Breach deck also. So I think we probably want to pod for Sin Collector next turn if possible. Yeah, looks like definitely. I think, if I remember correctly, this deck did not run Scapeshift, it was just like a Primeval Titan rampy sort of thing. Alright. Okay, so might as well attack. Could be that this is going to be our best Abrupt Decay target, but I don't even know that we want to cast Abrupt Decay. I think we probably just want to go Sin Collector and then play Ooze. Presumably playing Ooze off of a basic forest here. No real reason to take any additional damage. Well, if we get Spike Feeder, then we can go off next turn with Linvala. No, I think just the Sin Collector is going to be safer. Our clock is plenty fast. This hand is plenty bad. Alright. And Uzu. Hopefully he doesn't just like draw through the breach and kill us this turn. That would suck. Looks like no such bad luck. Alright, so we could Abrupt Decay the Chalice, play Noble Hierarch, eat two things with ooze, which I believe is the number of things that there are to eat with ooze. That would be 4, 8, 10 damage. Wouldn't get us out of Emrakul range, though, because we'd lose 2 to play this Temple Garden, so I don't like that. Because I would like to be out of Emrakul range. I guess if we play Linvala and Pod for Spike Feeder, we hit him for 8, so it's still a 2-turn clock, and then we have an Archangel in play, which is obviously protection from Emrakul. If we do get Emrakul, we can sacrifice like 5 lands and Elemental, Chump Block, and have an Ooze left over. Have Ooze, Sid Collector, Pod, which sounds like a pretty good amount to rebuild with, especially considering they both have counters. So that'll be 8 damage this turn, and then if they both get counters, that's only 6 damage the next turn. So really good if we had a land left over. I think it's pretty unlikely, obviously, that this actually happens to us next turn. But it's good to think ahead on how we can actually lose this game that we're so far ahead in. Additionally, if he Primeval Titans, he'd be able to just kill off our Archangel this way, which is, you know, obviously not great, but it's not the end of the world either. Yeah, he'd have to spend both the triggers on the Archangel, I'm pretty sure. Like, he could go for something else, but I don't think that would work out very well for him. Maybe actually we don't need to get the Archangel, maybe we just go get, like, Red Cap. It's a little safer against a Sweeper. And we have Lethal next turn anyway. Yeah, actually, I think that's good. So we can definitely kill next turn with Ooze. If this turns into Archangel next turn, we can kill with it anyway, so that's fine. I think just Red Cap as Sweeper protection. Siege Rhino, it's okay. Hard to kill. No, Red Cap's just better. Put more pressure on his life total. Now, if he Primeval Titans, he can kill like this and this, maybe. But that still leaves him dead on board. Because we go Decay Chalice. We're not quite dead on board. We can treat Not a Titan anyway, so it's not a big deal. Yeah, I think we're in very good shape here. Alright, looks like there is indeed a Primeval Titan coming down, as expected. And he's gonna find Valakut Mountain. And yeah, I think he has to actually just kill two of our, like, kill Ooze, kill Elemental Token, or he's just dead. As expected. So we can put him to 1 here. Does that change anything? Yeah, I think it actually does, because we can go Wall of Root. Oh no, because we. Oh no. Yeah, no, it doesn't work. I think we go Wall of Roots Pontiff, but we actually have to pot away the Red Cap to have it die. We can. So maybe we can kill him this turn. Probably not. Could Rough Decay Chalice. You can get Archangel into play, but that doesn't do much. Alright, well, I can't figure out a way to kill him this turn, so I'm gonna settle for putting him to one. This does leave us dead to a Through the Breach, which is a little bit unfortunate. I wish there was a way we could play around that, but I just don't think there is, considering he can 12 us with Valakut next turn. So we're dead to Through the Breach or another Primeval Titan. And I will be left wondering if we should have taken more aggressive lines in terms of getting a combo active. So we certainly could have, it just felt like it would expose us to sweepers a little more. Alright, I hope he doesn't I guess we're also just dead to like Farseek plus Mountain of some kind. So hopefully that's not what's going on. That would be pretty annoying. Yeah, I've never played against this deck before. It's pretty interesting. I wonder if I should have been trying to combo like more aggressively. But I think they have four main deck angers, so that seems pretty dicey. He does also have to kill literally every creature we have in play, which is going to be a challenge. Because like even if he just, I guess he could play Obstinate Bailoff as well. Alright. Well, I think we win. We'd have Summoning Trap, I guess. There's nothing I can do about that. Yeah, let's just go ahead and attack. I guess I'll attack with both in case he has some sort of removal spell. We can always Township. You'd think you just want to cast Summoning Trap on his turn, though. Because, like, if he hits a Primeval Titan, we're just straight up dead. Alright. Fingers crossed. If he hits Emrakul, we still win here. I mean, we could also hope that he has... Ah, that's really funny. So he had a Secure Tribe Elder, but actually can't activate it. So if he had... Yeah, if he'd killed off our Linvala, it'd be a lot better for him with the first two triggers. And then this one could kill off... Could block Noble Hierarch and kill our other two guys. Although that wouldn't work because we drew Township, but he didn't know that. That's very interesting. It looks like we win. Alright, well that was a close game for our opponent mulliganing to 5. So we want Entombed Exarch for sure, Sin Collector seems good, Thoughtseize is definitely good, Path seems pretty bad, Abrupt Decay seems horrible. Spellskite I think is fine because it dodges Anger of the Gods, which is a 4 of in his deck. Thrun actually seems, well I guess we have these now, so we don't need Thrun. And Vala does not seem great, even though it was secretly great in that game. Orzhov Pontiff seems very poor. I'm trying to envision a world where I bring an Eidolon of Rhetoric here. It does not seem good enough, but it might. I do value a 1-4 pretty highly, I'm just not sure what else we would cut. I guess scavenging ooze is not really at its best. It does, it messes with search for tomorrow also, which is kind of nice. Yeah, I'll try it. I don't, this is definitely a thing I'm not sure about. I doubt it's actually good. But we'll give it a whirl. Alright, on to game 2.